I'm very happy to be here to talk about my passion, about art, about color. Although I have to admit, I have to say to you that for me, talking about color feels really somehow counterintuitive in a way, because I can live color, I can paint color, I feel color very intuitively. So talking about it seemed quite a challenge, but okay, I decided I was going to do it anyway. And color is a very, very vast subject, as you can imagine. We can approach it from many, many different angles. We could talk about it, for example, from the point of view of, let's say, science. I could talk about how color, how we can distinguish between color. How do we know that red is red, or blue is blue? What happens in our eyes? What kind of signals travel through the brain? So this kind of thing seems interesting. Or we could talk about maybe some historical aspect of color. I personally have been fascinated with the color blue, with white and blue porcelain, for example, which came from China to Europe in the 14th century. And then became such a big part of the European history in different cities. Like in Delft, in St. Petersburg, you see white and blue porcelain that we now call China. All of these different aspects seem very interesting, but for me, at the end of the day, what seems relevant is to speak from my own experience, of course. I'll use beautiful words by Walt Whitman. Whatever satisfies the soul is truth. And my own soul is extremely happy when it is immersed in art. So let me speak about this subject from the perspective of my own truth. I'm an artist and I cannot imagine my life without color. I even organize things at home by color. I surround myself by colorful environments, consciously, really going for it. And I dream in color. I don't think I've ever had a black and white dream in my life. Besides color, what is very important for me, or let's say natural, is metaphor, because I tend to perceive reality through metaphors. And metaphor is a thing, an object, which symbolizes something else, which symbolizes, for example, an idea. For example, in this image of a painting called Forbidden Pear, you see a fruit, but when I was painting it, I wasn't painting a fruit, so I wasn't taking a pear and just copying a pear. It is a symbol of something else. And this painting is part of the series of seven paintings in total, which is called Forbidden Fruit. So Forbidden Fruit series. There's seven different forbidden fruit, and it's again a metaphor of many more things. So today I thought an idea for this speech that I had was to combine both color and metaphor, because for me color can be a metaphor for life itself, for being in the flow of life, for being in the midst of circumstances that you have created for yourself, so really being in the midst of the flow of life. So I'm going to speak about color as a symbol of life today. Very often people ask me, where do your vibrant colors come from? And they look at my art and they see something like this, or this is the painting that you see there on the wall, or here's another one. And sometimes they ask me, well, were you born in some kind of an exotic country, growing up surrounded by explosive colors in nature, in architecture? But this is not at all the case. I was born in Latvia, so one of the Baltic states, surrounded by a very quiet, subtle palette like this. So this is a typical paysage that I could stare at for hours and hours and hours and never get tired of it. So to those people who ask me these questions, I don't have the answer. I don't know. I can't explain where at least I don't see the link between where I come from and the colors of my art. And I also think that very often human mind is extremely focused on finding these links, cause and effect, trying to find explanations, trying to look back constantly and trying to understand why things are happening the way they are. But I think that the beauty of living life, the beauty of life experiences is actually quite the opposite. It is not in constantly trying to analyze circumstances. It's rather in abandoning our desire to find these explanations. So I think this is really happiness is really in the enjoyment of what is there in front of you, without searching for the proof, without looking back in the past or trying to predict the future. And so our lives, I think, become much more vibrant and more colorful if we become open to the experiences that surround us at this very moment, allowing all colors to come into our experience. I want to share with you beautiful words of Khalil Gibran. Let me bathe my soul in colors. Let me swallow the sunset and drink the rainbow. So let's be open to all the colorful experiences in our lives. And now, imagine your life as a blank white canvas. And of course, here I'm using canvas again as a metaphor of something new, a new beginning, a metaphor of your whole life. I know that amongst many people who are beginning to experiment with art, with expressing themselves through painting, there is often a lot of fear to face a blank white canvas, especially if it's a big canvas. Okay, so we don't know yet, we're not sure about our skills, what is going to appear on the canvas in the end. We're often afraid of other people's judgments. And so often we just don't take this first step. But you have to do it. There's no other choice, because once you start, with every stroke of brush, you add more color. And the same thing about life, with every experience, your perception of reality grows, your life begins vibrant, full of color, begins vibrating with color. So the more fully you live your life, the more you experience, and the more color there is on the canvas of your life. Sometimes you notice that color appears on the canvas as if by chance. You didn't plan it. It's just kind of there. You didn't even think of using that particular color. It sort of showed up. It's the same in your life. Sometimes you didn't expect your life to turn in a certain way, but it just did. And this is fine. Because, again, we can't predict everything. We have to be open to this flow that carries us in life. But at the same time, you have to remember that you actually have much more power in yourself to choose your colors. So you are able to decide what colors go on your palette, both in art and in life. Now what if black, a lot of black starts appearing on your canvas, or the canvas of your life? People often tend to look at different things, labeling them as black or white, as negative or positive, and they stop seeing other colors. But actually, there's a lot of black in my paintings, and like on this one, for example, and I think that some of them wouldn't be as powerful if I didn't use black, because I think that black has a lot of powerful force to it. So start noticing black and white, and then you will see that other colors will start showing up. Maybe you will see that 50 shades of gray start appearing or more, and then you will start noticing other hues and colors, shades. In 1810, a book by Goethe appeared. It was called Theory of Colors. It wasn't a scientific study of color. It was a rather philosophical, artistic expression of what color is. And an interesting part of that book was, an interesting idea was that Goethe has refused Newton's color spectrum by saying that that darkness, that black, is not the absence of light. It is actually an active ingredient. So he said that color itself is a degree of darkness. I think it's a very beautiful metaphor again, that if you have darkness or black, don't treat it as something necessarily negative. Can treat it with respect and noticing that your experience grows when you simply start becoming aware of the presence of black and white and then gray and then allowing more and more color to come into your life. A combination of black and white is interestingly used in visual communications, such as in movies, for example, to symbolize different states and switches of states between black and white, symbolizing a state of dullness, even death. And when other colors come in, then a whole change of state, change of energy happens, and life starts to vibrate. For example, in the 1939 Hollywood movie The Wizard of Oz, when Dorothy lives in her little town leading an ordinary life, the movie is shot in black and white. And when she pushes that magic door, secret door to the magic world over the rainbow, the movie is in color, and that part of the movie is in color. And when she comes back, it's again in black and white. So it's a very strong symbol. And another example that I want to share with you is how we perceive black and white old photos. And we often think that, you know, in the past, life used to be black and white, and that these photos they belong to the realm of history museums, and we start even imagining life in the past as black and white. But some modern day photographers have colorized many of these white and black photos, and I don't know if you can see very well, still the colors are still are quite subtle here, but the photo becomes more alive when there is some color added to it. It's no longer a history book, it's a real life situation. Another one from following the same idea is this one, and this is actually even more rare example of an old photo because it was originally made in color and more than 100 years ago. It was a Russian photographer who invented a color camera and he was using it to take these photos, and this was taken during the times of Tsarist Russia, for example, or this one. Look at that. The clothes, of course, look as, you know, as they used to look in that period of time, but the nature looks perfectly, it could be a nature, I mean, just a nature, the same way as it looks today. So it all becomes astonishingly real with color. For me, I like very much this idea of expressing something through color, and especially by using this combination of black and white or subtle colors to express the state of stillness. So this is a painting. Actually, it's not a perfect image of it. I have to say, there's a lot more of white color there and silver glow. You can't see it really, but it's called Frozen Rivers. And the idea here is that in our lives, often we go through long periods of time when, as if nothing is happening, and we meet our friends and people say, "Well, what's new?" And there's nothing new. And for years and years and years, and we think that nothing is happening. But deep down, a huge change might be taking place. And this is a painting I created, I think last winter, and it was when everything was completely frozen. But I knew that a lot of things would start happening soon. It was just life was at the bottom of the frozen rivers. And here I wrote something that to say that sometimes a very strong, powerful change takes time to come to the surface, to come into effect. You just have to have a little bit of patience. And importantly, you have to trust in the natural progression of things without necessarily pushing them to happen, because spring comes. I'm enchanted by color, and one of my series of paintings, which are called 7x7, is dedicated entirely to the color. So the idea here is that there are seven paintings with seven flowers on each of them, and each of the main colors represented here is one of the colors of the rainbow. So lots of symbols here. And when I was creating this series, I was inspired by very simple, authentic things, flowers, rainbows, something so simple and natural that we often don't even take notice of these things. We know they're there, we're happy, of course, but we don't consciously notice them as much as we probably should. And these are things that people have been fascinated with, they have marveled at since the dawn of humanity. And so that's the yellow, actually the first one was red, the second is this one, the orange. And that's the yellow, and that's the green. So when I was creating this series, I thought about how colors, which were once something only nature possessed, came into our reality and surround us now in our everyday objects. So if we want to create a vibrant canvas of our lives, we should become painters or artists, at least in a kind of a symbolic way. If we become a creator, there are two things happening, and very important ones, and I mentioned them already, but I want to repeat. On the one hand, you have to remember that you have a choice. You have a choice to select the colors that you want, just as an artist can do. You can decide which of them end up on your palette, and then even then you have a choice. Maybe some of them will not even end up on the canvas. So you have power in many situations in your life. And on the other hand, this is something completely the opposite in a way. You have to be able to surrender yourself to the flow of life. and not trying to control it. So this, these seem, in a way, as two mutually exclusive kind of attitudes. Different, it's a different type of attitude to life, but it's possible to combine them. On the one hand, controlling, knowing that you have control and power, and on the other hand, going with the flow. And this is how I do it in my art, for sure. And in my life, I'm trying as well. So at the beginning, you might start by observing just black and white, and then even if for a while these are the only two colors in your palette, that's fine. Don't judge them. And if you stop judging them as negative or positive, other colors come in and life starts coming to the surface, like in the Frozen Rivers painting. And then spring comes. So that's the last one in this series. So this one is another one. It's another series called The Flow. And here, again, I don't paint fish for the sake of painting fish. For me, these are all symbols of going with the flow, of not struggling against this stream of life. And so I wish you to make an effort to make the canvas of your life become part of the flow of your life. If you become the bright fish swimming along the stream, not against it, not struggling with it, then you will be able to accept the vibrant flow of life and open up to all its colors. Okay, that's another one. Be in the flow. Thank you very much. That's something also to inspire you, maybe. One of my favorite quotes by Kandinsky, and my contact details here.